बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। आई एम साजिया नसीम फ्रॉम भेड़िया फाउंडेशन कॉलेज नौशेर ऑफ रोज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर ऑन बॉटनी। एज वी ऑल नो स्टूडेंट्स, टू टीचर्स दे आर मैडम सलमा एंड साजिया विल टीच यू बायोलॉजी, मैम सलमा विल टीच यू जूलॉजी एंड आई विल टीच द बॉटनी। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नंबर 2। चैप्टर इज स्ट्रक्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ लाइफ, सब्जेक्ट इज बॉटनी। Let's start now. First of all, we will define cell. What is cell? Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life. What does it mean? How we call cell is the structural and functional unit of life. We all listen and we all read from many years that everything is made up of cell. Let's take the example of a building. For example, a building is made up of different bricks. Like this is a wall. A wall is made up of bricks. Now, what is the basic unit of this wall? Basic unit is a single brick. In the same way, the basic unit of our body or a basic unit of body of every living organism is the cell. What is the basic unit of every living organism? That is cell. How cells combine? Cells combine with each other and make tissue. And tissues combine, they make organ. Different organs, when they combine, they make organ system, and different system combine, they make the organism. Now, let's take the example of our cardiac cell. Cardiac cell, it's the cell of our heart. Cardiac cells, they combine together, they make our cardiac tissue. They make our cardiac tissue of our hearts. Different tissues, they make an organ which is called the heart. Heart is organ of our body, most important organ. Cardiac tissue, cardiac cells, they combine, they make the cardiac tissue. And cardiac tissues, when they combine, they make the heart. Now, heart only can't do anything with our body. Heart has to work with the different veins, different arteries. So, heart plus blood plus veins plus arteries plus capillaries. They all together make an organ system. Which system these made? That is the our blood circulatory system. Blood circulatory system. Now, can a person stay alive if he has only one system, blood circulatory system? No, he needs many systems in his body. Like he needs the digestive system, he also needs the respiratory system, he also needs the excretory reproductive system. 7 systems which combine to make a living organism. All systems are necessary in the body. So different systems, different organ systems, when they combine with each other, they make an organism. Now, you understand how a cell is the structural and functional unit of body. A structure of body is made up of cell. Each and every part of body is made up of cell. And the cells, when they combine with each other, they make tissue. Then tissues make organ, organs make organ system, and then organism. All cells are not similar in the body. All cells are not similar in the body. Different cells are different in shapes, for and they are specific for their functions. For example, we took the example of cardiac cell. There are some cells which are for the excretion. There are some cells which are for the blood circulation. Some cells which are specific for digestion. So every cell is specific in its structure for its function. Now let's come to the discovery of the cell. Who discovered the cell? Cell was discovered in 1965. And who was the scientist who discovered the cell? He was Robert Hooke. Robert Hooke was the scientist who discovered the cell. Robert Hooke was the Scientist he observed a slice of cork under compound microscope. Before the discovery of cell, there was no compound microscope. In fact, discovery of every scientific event or every scientific anything which is discovered, that is related with the discovery of the technology. As we have more and more advanced technology, we have more and more discoveries. So before the compound microscope, scientists had the simple microscope. Simple microscope was not able to show the cell. As the compound microscope was discovered, scientists observed the cell under the microscope. The major difference in simple and compound microscope is that simple microscope has only one lens and compound microscope have more than one lenses. So Robert Hooke was the scientist. In 1965, he observed the cell under the compound microscope. Now, we have two types of cell, two major types of cell, that is prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells are two major types of cell. There is some difference in between both types. We will learn the difference between two types. First difference between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell is that prokaryotic cell is very simple type of cell, while eukaryotic cell is complex. It is not very simple. Nuclear membrane is absent in prokaryotic cell, while the eukaryotic cell nuclear membrane is present. So if nuclear membrane is absent, it means it has no specific nucleus. DNA is scattered. DNA is scattered. As we learned the structure of the cell, every cell has outermost layer which is called the cell membrane. Inside the membrane there is cytoplasm and then nucleus. How we identify nucleus? Because nucleus has the specific membrane called nuclear membrane. Like this is a cell and this is its nucleus. But in case of prokaryotic cells, this cell wall is present. Inside the cell wall there is cytoplasm, but this nuclear membrane is absent in the cytoplasm. So we cannot differentiate between nucleus and the cytoplasm in this case. Cell wall, cell membrane is present in the eukaryotic cell. As cell membrane is present, it means nucleus is also present, nuclear membrane is present and nucleus is also present. Now the many membrane bounded organelles are absent in the prokaryotic cell. Which are these membrane bounded organelles? For example, mitochondria, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, many other organelles which are called the cytoplasmic organelles. They are present in the cytoplasm. They are absent in prokaryotic cell, but all these cytoplasmic organelles are present in the eukaryotic cell like this. Cell wall is present in prokaryotic cell, but cell wall is not made up of cellulose. As we know that cell wall is the outermost layer of the plant cells. In animal cells, cell wall is absent. Cell wall is present in the eukaryotic cell. But this cell wall is not made up of cellulose. It is mostly made up of peptidoglycan or mucin. This is DNA which is in scattered form. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan or glucin. Then cell wall is absent in animal cells, but it is present in plant cell. So cell wall of plant cells in eukaryotic cells is made up of cellulose. Here cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan or mucin, but in case of eukaryotic cells, cell wall is made up of cellulose. Now take the example of prokaryotic cell. We have bacteria and cyanobacteria. Bacteria is strictly prokaryotic and unicellular organism. Cyanobacteria is also prokaryotic organism. यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स हैव एल्गी, फंजाई, प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स, दे आर ऑल यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स. नाउ वी हैव द सेल थ्योरी. एज वी लर्न अबाउट द सेल, वी हैव नोन दैट सेल इज द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ द लाइफ. नाउ वी लर्न अबाउट द सेल थ्योरी. सेल थ्योरी इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द सेल बायोलॉजी. इनफैक्ट ऑल सेल बायोलॉजी डिपेंड अपॉन द सेल थ्योरी. branch of biology in which we study about the cell, that is called the cell biology. And we can say the cell theory is the backbone of cell biology. We can call it cell theory is the backbone of the cell biology. It means cell theory is most important to understand. There are three most important postulates of cell theory. First of all organisms are composed of one or more cells. We have also learned in cell definition, cell is the basic structural and functional unit of the life. In other words, we can also say that all organisms are composed of one or more cells. As you know, if a cell is organism is made up of one cell, that is called the unicellular organism. And if a cell is made up of more than one cell, that is called the multicellular organism. So all the living things, all living organisms, they are composed of one or more cells. Organism which is made up of one cell, that is called the unicellular organism, and organism which is made up of more than one cell, that is called the multicellular organism. Second postulate of cell theory is all cells arise from the pre-existing cells. It means cell cannot be created automatically. We cannot create cell. Cell come from the parent cell. Pre-existing cells, they are their parent cells. Parent cell divide, new cells arise. For example, this is a parent cell. It will divide into two or four daughter cells. New arising cells are called the daughter cells. The process of cell division may be mitosis or meiosis. There are two types. It will learn it in next lectures. So here it is important to learn that cell cannot be automatically created. Cell arise from pre-existing cell. Cell arise from the pre-existing cell. In class 8 we have learned the experiments of Reddy and other scientists who perform different experiments to show that cell cannot be created or cell cannot be automatically destroyed. It come from the pre-existing cell. And third postulate of cell theory is the cell is the structural and functional unit of all organisms. There are three most important postulates of the cell theory. It was our lecture today. Now let's revise it. What we learned today, first of all I told you the cell definition. What was the definition of cell? Cell is the structural and functional unit of the life. And cells combine, they make the tissue, and tissues combine organ. Organs when combined, they make the organ system. And different systems combine to make the organism. So, the discovery of cell. Cell was discovered by Robert Hooke. He observed the slice of cork under microscope. And slice of cork looked like this. Like chambers. He observed different chambers under microscope. Different chambers under the compound microscope. These different chambers were like honeybee comb. Honeybee comb look like this. It has different chambers in itself. He named each chamber as the cell. He named each chamber cell. In compound microscope, he observed only the cell. The compound microscope was not able to show the internal parts of the cell like nucleus or other cytoplasmic organelles, DNA. It was possible after the discovery of light microscope. So, After cell, we learned the two major types of cell, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. What was the main difference between two types of cell? Prokaryotic cell was very simple cell and eukaryotic cell was a complex cell. Prokaryotic cell had no nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane was absent in prokaryotic cell and present in eukaryotic cell. If nuclear membrane is absent, it means there is no specific nucleus inside the nuclear membrane. No, it has specific membrane in the eukaryotic cell. In eukaryotic cell, there is specific nucleus. There is no distinguishable, no observable nucleus in the prokaryotic cell. But DNA is present. DNA is the genetic material of cell. It is present in every living thing. DNA present, but it is not bounded. It is in the scattered form. We cannot differentiate between the cytoplasm and nucleus. And this is the cytoplasm of the cell and this is the nucleus of the cell. In prokaryotic cell, we cannot differentiate between nucleus and cytoplasm. Cell wall is present in prokaryotic cell, but it is made up of peptidoglycan or mucin. It is not made up of cellulose. It is made up of peptidoglycan or mucin. In eukaryotic cells, cell wall is present only in plant cells. Always keep in mind, cell wall is present only in plant cells. In animal cells, cell wall is not present. Animal cells don't have cell wall. Outermost layer of animal cell is the cell membrane. This is animal cell. But if cell wall is present in plant cells, it is made up of cellulose. It is not made up of peptidoglycan. Example of the eukaryotic cells are algae, fungi, plants, animals. Different organisms, mostly they are eukaryotic cells. Then we studied the cell theory. I told cell theory is the basically, it is backbone of cell biology. All cell biology depends upon this cell theory. There are three most important postulates of cell theory, which are: number one, all organisms are composed of one or more cells. If organism is composed of a single cell, it is called the unicellular cell organism. And if organism is made up of more than one cell, it is called the multicellular organism. Second most important postulate of our theory is cell arise from pre-existing cells. Cells always arise from pre-existing cells. Pre-existing cells are also known as parent cells and newly born cells are called the daughter cells. All cells, they arise from the pre-existing cell by the process of cell division. A single cell divides into two daughter cells in case of mitosis. Third postulate of cell is the cell theory, that is, cell is the structural and functional unit of all organisms. Cell is the structural and functional unit of organism. This statement we have discussed previous in definition of cell also. Now your homework. Our lecture is complete here. Today we will read up to here. Is now what is your homework you have to do? First of all, you have to listen the lecture carefully, then you will read this lecture from your books and memo the cell definition. You will read the lecture from your book, then you will draw a label diagram plant and animal cell from your 8th class science books. In 8th class, there is a science book you have learned about the cell. You cite the cells and then draw a neat and labeled diagram of plant cell and animal cell. Also write down date of your homework and submit this homework when you will ask to submit the homework in your college. Thank you.